following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Seem in Dallas.
Hi, Tom. I love your show.
Thank you so much.
I've been listening to you since 2001 from my Seattle days when you were on a little station there.
I appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here, man. Thank you. Well, listen, thanks for bringing us from Seattle to Dallas, man. Appreciate it.
Yeah. I love all the hosts. I love your show. I'm addicted to it.
It's Hotel California. It's wicked, isn't it, man?
Thanks. All right, Tom. Nice
okay,
to
man.
Talk to you.
Have a great one. Have a safe one.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Learn to ask questions. It is always better to ask questions than to make an assumption. Have the courage to ask questions and to as clear as you can be. Once you hear the answer to the question, you won't have to make the assumption because you will know the truth. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We had the Dow Industrials finish up 297 points. NASDAQ up 60, S&P's up 27. Gold contract up $4.50, trading at $1,174.50 an ounce. Silver up 38 cents at $17.19 an ounce. Platinum up $6, $9.41 an ounce. Copper down 3.5 pennies at $2.63 a pound. Light sweet crude off $1, trading at $49.91 a barrel. Bonds, the 10-year note up 11 ticks, 124.26. 30-year bond up 28 ticks, 151.05. King dollar down 295 ticks, trading at 100.235. The euro is at 107. And the yen is trading at 113.78. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? Okay, you broke out. You ripped the 2213 apart. You're at 2237 on the cash S&P. Volume-wise, what we have out here, this is what you have here. And with a billion versus 885 million yesterday. Dow Industrials make another new high. Dow Industrials up 297 points. You have wide price spread. I mean, this is pretty intense. You're also at a price point of 19,558. That was the high you hit. It's like, okay, why not hit 20,000, right? What it kind of seems like, folks. That's the bottom line. Composite, NASDAQ composite. Now, this is where it gets a little bit different. The composite had the price spread, good price spread, $60. You didn't do the volume, you did 2 billion shares. Well, you're going into the highs. These highs will get hit tomorrow. So you get 54.03. And right now we're at 53.93. You know, bottom line, I expect you're going to see them get hit. If you do that correlation, when you're looking at how we've come into this, you know, the price spread's a big deal. You've come into it with 2 billion shares. That's versus the 2.2 billion on the way down, the 2 billion on the way down. So we'll see where that whole thing does shake out. The NDX 100, now this is still the weak link. It's pretty amazing, actually. So the NDX, the high of the NDX is 49.11. We're at 48.51. Bottom line, go over to the Qs. You can see the Qs. Folks just aren't buying the tech stocks. The Qs did 25 million shares, which is a good jump up from where we were at 20 past 3, because we were 21 million. But still not huge. Last high we made out here was at 18 million, and I gave it up with 30. Right now, the Qs are trading at $118.36. The 119.51 is the last high that was generated up here on the 29th. The low of that high was 118.30. You know, so you whack that high, you get into it, you close the into it, 6 pennies, that says the top of that will now get hit. Gold contract. What do we have with gold? Gold contract out here traded from a price point today of 1167 to 1182. We're at 1175. Good volume. What I do want to see inside this contract, though, we need more price spread. I do expect we're going to see it test the 1190. We'll see whether it has the strength as it gets up into that level. Silver is proving itself out here today. Silver, if you happen to be in the metals market, silver is a good indication that it's going to drag gold higher with it. And what you have is this. Silver did 62,000 contracts. You're up 37 cents. We hit a high today of $17.30. A close inside $17.24 to 26 cents will put you in the higher range. The higher range specifically is after it got toasted and roasted on the 11th of November. That's when we went down and all the metals. Silver happened to go from $18.95 to $17.20. Notes and bonds. Notes and bonds are still trying to get off their lows. It's doing like a, if you just take a horseshoe and put it as a horseshoe is, that's what we're doing off these lows. So in this contract here, meaning we're in the March 2017 contract, the low of that this contract on the 10-year is 123.19. Right now you're at 124.26. And, you know, we did 800,000 contracts. The bonds, the notes, need like 1.2 million contracts. We go over and we take a look at the bonds. And what you have with the bonds, we did 167,000 contracts. What we want to see is 267,000. So we want to see another 100,000 contracts, big numbers that we're going to need in those bonds for higher price. King Dollar, what do we have with King Dollar? Bottom line, King Dollar is having a hard time holding the 100.600 mark. King Dollar, it looks like it's an ABC structure on the way down. You know, we broke with wide price spread and accelerated volume on Monday. You did a counter trend bounce today and yesterday. You can see the correlation down with 80,000 contracts, up yesterday with 32,000. You got to a higher high today with 26, gave it up on price. It's going to go after the B point tomorrow, which is $99.87. And we'll see whether we get an ABC structure on the way down. The amazing part about this, at this particular point, it's like, guess what? When the dollar was going up, the market was going up. Dollar's going down, the market's still going up. So the correlation of the dollar right now doesn't seem to matter which way the dollar goes. The market continues to go at a higher price. We look at the XAU. The XAU is trading at $82.57. And this already got back inside its higher range. Inside $79.88 gets it back inside the range, which it did. Gold Bugs Index still needs some help. That's at 183. Volume wasn't bad the last couple of days, but Gold Bugs Index has a much further reach in order to get back inside that range. That would have to be up to the $195.61. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming back. Lululemon. Let's see. Lululemon closed at $59.84. That is trading at 66.51. They just come up with numbers. We'll come back with those numbers for you. Be right back.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit TFNN.com.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at nadex.com. That's nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of tfnn.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go over to Lululemon and see what they have to say. So, okay, so Lululemon, their margin, the estimated margin was 49.3%. They got their margins up to 51%. The earnings, 43 cents was the estimate. They made 47. Net revenue, okay, so for the year, they had seen... for the year, they see net revenue of $2.3 billion to $2.34 billion. Fourth quarter net revenue, they see from $765 million to $785 million. So the fourth quarter is a big quarter for them. No two ways about that. Lululemon soared as much as 14% late trading after third quarter earnings blew past analyst estimates. And the yoga wear maker said sales have strengthened heading into holiday season. Profit in the quarter was 47 cents a share, excluding some items. The Vancouver-based company said in a statement Wednesday, the results suggest Lululemon has renewed momentum following concerns that discounting and sluggish retail traffic would weigh on sales. Lululemon closed at, closed at $59.84. That is trading now at $66. And if we take a look at this, so Lululemon, this just came down from 81. So it was trading 81 in August, gets down to 54, going back up to 66. So you're going back up to where the stock got toasted in September. The week of September, first week of September, Lululemon went from $79 to 68. Now coming right back into that area. We'll see whether it can take that area out. We put this on a larger monthly. What you're going to see is that Lululemon's still in a consolidation. That's how it's shaken out. And now it wants to run to the top of that consolidation. We take a look at the XLF. So what was kind of intriguing out here today, you know, the XLF goes to a new high. New high meaning in the last couple of years. Well, the last couple of years, I believe it is. Yeah, it is. We are at we're at a price point of 23.48. But if we go to J.P. Morgan, it was interesting. Yeah, J.P. Morgan's up 38 cents. BRK I believe Berkshire Hathaway is the largest weighting inside. Oh, there she is. Yep. So Berkshire Hathaway was up 335. Berkshire, this is pretty amazing. For Berkshire, since the election, has gone from 145 to 164. You talk about putting some juice into a stock. Pretty amazing. If you want to see something that's really bizarre, so check this out. We'll go to the, changes up. I'll go to the A shares of Berkshire Hathaway. So the A shares of Berkshire Hathaway right now trade at $246,380.05. They're up $4,500 today. And so check this out. You're going to love this. There was 830 shares traded today at $250,000 apiece, approximately. Pretty amazing. We bring this back. Let's put this back. So here, I got to see this in this context. Okay. So if you bought Berkshire Hathaway, it's percentage-wise it's the same, but man, this is big money. If you had bought it the day of the election, it was $219,000. It's $246,000 now. And when you put this on a monthly basis, your swing point at 9,800. Well, this is intense. So check this out. Wow. Man, this is going to be a trip if this is it looks like it's an ABC up. Okay, so let me find this. This could be insane. Okay, so on Berkshire Hathaway, it broke a B point with volume. The real question is, let me put this on that's on a monthly. Wow. Okay. Pretty cool. Let me see which point I'm going to come off here for a second. You can just about do it. Okay, this is going to be close. What the close call is, folks, is that when we get an ABC up, you need straight line moves. And then you can't do more than a 0.618 retracement. So this is a ballpark, but it looks like 163... to 229, you got what that's 37, 47, 57, 67, which would give you 714. I see. Yeah. It's a little bit higher than this. 256, around 256. Right now you're at 146. Pretty intense, no doubt. Let's go take a look at Toll Brothers. So Toll Brothers came out with numbers yesterday. Numbers weren't bad. Toll Brothers are going $32.61. Now, this took out its last swing point. And if we put this, it's going to need a lot more juice on the weekly. But it looks like right now the Toll Brothers on its way to a 34.49. Let's go take a look at Lennar. Because what you have, the amount of bread, that has been generated in this market that are going to be people's accounts is pretty intense. There's no doubt about that, whether the IRAs or whatever. Lennar is up $1.25 at 44.67. 44.69 looks like it wants to go after. What we also have out here, which is a little bit different in the context of the market going up this dramatically, you also had bonds go up. When you get a market that runs like this, it's like totally makes sense that bonds would go down, but guess what? They didn't. There was actually nothing that was going down at all. We'll actually except gasoline. If we go over to the gasoline market, you'll see that number two, unleaded, came off the highs. We are trading at a price point of $1.52. The highs 2 days ago is $1.58, and that's back inside the range. So back inside the range, that says that, longer term, meaning next 4-6 weeks, whatever, that can get back down to 128. Now, if we bring this back a little bit further, XB1. Okay, so I put this on a continuous contract. So on a continuous contract, what it did is this. We got to the top of the consolidation, and it just couldn't handle it. If you, when we go back in 2014, of course, unleaded gas wholesale was $3.15. Crashed down to the January of 2015 to 122. It's been this consolidation now, the one we're in since August of 2016. The top of that consolidation is $1.66. The bottom of this consolidation is 127. So regardless of the Saudis saying that they're going to keep the price of crude up, the distillates, the gasolines, bottom line, looks like there's plenty of them and they're going south. Dow Industrials finished up 297, NASDAQ up 60, S&P's up 26. You stay right there, folks. We'll come right back.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
It's 2016 and TFNN has a brand new programming lineup to kick things off. Starting January 4th, Swim Lessons by Thinkorswim and TD Ameritrade will be airing 5 days a week at noon Eastern Time. Join hosts Scott Connor, Kevin Hinks, and Cindy Faber as they host their daily options program live at noon 5 days a week with no commercials for the entire hour. Nico DeHaan and Paige Clark will be moving their program, Living a Primal Lifestyle, to twice a week, Tuesdays and Thursdays from 7 a.m. until 8 a.m. Eastern Time. Wake up with Nico and Paige and start your day off right. The Bull Bear Binary Option Hour by Nadex will now be live Mondays and Fridays at 10 a.m. Start and end the week with the three hosts, Tom O'Brien, Tommy O'Brien, and Daryl Martin, as they break down the world of trading binary options and spreads. For all the details on the new 2016 programming lineup, visit the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. And there was there's a great question that's in the den, folks. And what it was is this. Can this market rally to a year end without a week-long pullback? And I answered yes, sick and yes. I remember 1999. So here, let's do this first. I want to go... I believe the biggest run thus far has been the Dow. So the Dow has gone from 18,200 to 19,000. So that's gone up 1,300 points. Big numbers. And huge numbers, no doubt. And there's another question there. No shots left to push it, so we'll have to be buying, okay? So the speculation would be, and I think the speculation is correct, outside of the NDX 100, is that when you get an expansion like this with the type of price spread, inside the S&Ps, people are flat. If they don't want to go long, they're flat. They're not shot any longer. Now, what I want to do, though, is I'm going to go back. I'm going to pull up the NDX for us. I'm going to pull up the NASDAQ composite for us because I believe that the run in 1999 was 30% in 6 weeks. I mean, I remember this because I remember we had a couple ABC structures on the way up. JDSU, we did, it was a 225-point ABC structure on the way up. It was insane, and it hit it like in 3 weeks. Yeah, so if we go back there, I got this up here right now. So if we go back, what you're going to see, this is crazy, actually. Yeah, in September, the NASDAQ was at 2,600. And by March, it was 51. Yeah, so that's, okay, so it doubled from September to March. Just September to the end of the year, it went from 2,600 to 4,000. So, yeah, Qualcomm. Oh, yeah, Qualcomm, man. That was a Qualcomm 220. Yeah, it was Qualcomm. Was it Qualcomm? I forget. It didn't matter what you bought. It was crazy. Let's go to Brent in Martinez, California. Hey, Brent, what's going on, brother?
Hey, Tom, how are you?
Doing great, man. Yourself?
I'm doing well, thank you.
Cool.
I'd like to take a little bit of your time to ask more of a general question about the mining stocks.
Yeah.
And specifically what I would like to know is regionally, if you had a choice, I don't do a lot of fundamental, but you see, obviously know more about that than I do. As far as like the United States, Mexico, it seems to me that the South African stocks are having some trouble. And is there something politically there that you know about? That's what I kind of want to know from you. What areas you would prefer to be in as far as regionally, what you prefer?
The best deal, this is how this kind of works. So check this out. So you have, it has the mining business in general, folks, right? And the commodities are all run by the U.S. dollar. So what ends up happening is that when on your balance sheet, if in fact you have, if you're dealing in U.S. dollars and you're getting paid in U.S. dollars, it's a lot easier to figure out fundamentally what's going on with the stock, okay? That's why what happens there is that when you do see that they're both going up pretty good, you get McEwen Mining. I mean, almost his whole business is in Nevada, okay? So that's pretty good, okay, in that aspect, right? Now let's go over to the South Africa, right? Two different things end up happening in South Africa. So let's bring up Harmony first. We can bring up Harmony. So Harmony's trading at a low, $2.22. This was the first equity that actually took off in January, right? I mean, November, this equity's 54 cents, and then the thing took off to $4, right? Now, what that was all about, and this would be the ultimate in really making money, and what it is that the Rand dollar, you know, went up to 17.9 Rand dollars to one U.S. dollar. Now we're at 13.4 Rand dollars to one U.S. dollar. So what happens here is this, is that they have a law in South Africa. They can't keep U.S. dollars. They can't, in fact, keep anything except the Rand. They have to transfer it, and I believe it's within 90 days they get a transfer. They have a whole structure how to do it. So what happens is this, is that everyone gets paid in Rand dollars in South Africa, including in mining. Harmony. Harmony has 27,000 employees. So when the Rand dollar was getting so weak, and then you had the gold contract getting strong, that was the best of both worlds for them. That's why that stock went from, you know, 50 cents to whatever, $5 or whatever it was. Okay, so now let's talk about the Canadian stocks. What happens with the Canadian stocks, let's go over to GG. And you have Goldcorp, and Goldcorp is gonna have their expenses in Canadian dollars, and they're still getting paid in American dollars. So it's like, okay, you know, the Canadian dollar right now is at $1.32. You know, you're down from 146, thank God. You know, it looks to me that, and this is where it would help the Canadian stock, if I'm right on the dollar call, Brent, meaning the dollar's going to pull back, the Canadian dollar will get stronger, and we don't want it to get really strong, because if it gets really strong, then what ends up happening is that hurts the Canadian stocks too. So you got to pay attention to what their expenses are in. That's what it really comes down to, man, you know?
Okay, so it's more of a currency issue than politically being a problem.
Yeah, yes, it is. Yeah, for sure. It's the cross trade of what
their currency is to our dollar.
Yeah, exactly, because they're getting paid in U.S. dollars. Yeah.
Okay.
Exactly.
All right. Go ahead.
If you go over to Rangel, what Rangel does is this. Now, Rangel, folks, their business, a lot of their business is in West Africa. And, you know, what they do, they have a lot of euros and a lot of dollars. That's how they kind of do it. They don't deal in, you know, the West currency, the currency in West Africa. You know, so.
Okay, so they're not so tied to the RAND like Harmony is.
They are not.
Okay.
Right.
Okay.
Harmony's definitely tied to the RAND. And then what also happens is that Harmony and Goldfields, the difference is that they take out millions of ounces of gold, right? But it's a very high cost. So what happens is this, is that as gold's, out here at 1175, they're probably still just breaking even, okay? You go up $200, though, and what ends up happening is that's where you'll see that expansion in the South African stocks because of the fact that these other equities, let's say these other equities are taking out 600,000 ounces a year, which is still a lot. Harmony's taking out 2 million ounces a year, you know? So their acceleration and the amount of leverage that they have when the price of gold gets higher goes astronomical, you know.
Okay, that makes sense.
And here, I'm going to show you something else out here, folks. Okay, now we own the stock, but I can tell you, when this stock starts moving, you watch that gold market. When Vista Gold starts moving, which it did, just went from 85 cents to $1.10 in 2 days, 3 days, that's a good indication. And this is still an exploration play, and it's really a play on Australia. But that's always a good indication that these equities want to move higher. Cooking, brother.
All right. Thank you, Tom. Take care.
You too. Thanks for the call. Stay right there, folks. We're coming right back.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a 2-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
Take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. And, you know, in the commodity business, you talk about a comeback. This is pretty amazing because, you know, of course, you know, we have the Tiger's Den, which is a trading room, folks. If you haven't test drove it yet, come on over to TFNN. Great time to test drive it. You know, but I remember last year, we're talking many times inside here. Glencore was a company that no doubt looked like it was just going out of business. I mean, big time, too. Well, guess what? In the course of 1 year, they not only came back, and they sold a huge amount of assets, too, to stay in business. But bottom line, when you know how to cut to the chase, which this CEO did, guess what? He's back, and he's back, and he's bold. This just came across the tape. Russia sold 11.3 billion stake in its largest oil producer, the commodity trader Glencore PLC, and Qatar's sovereign wealth fund in a triumph for President Putin, who announced the deal on state television. The reason it would be a triumph, folks, yeah, I'll read this through, is because of the sanctions that are on Russia right now. You know, internationally, give me a break. It doesn't matter. You get oil, someone's going to buy it. And a surprise deal that leaves the EU sanctions against Russia looking pretty threadbare. The buyers will share a 19.5% stake in the state-run company, which pumps 5 million barrels a day, the biggest investment in Russia since the crisis in Ukraine. It also marks a stunning return to deal-making for Glencore CEO Ivan Glasenberg, little more than a year after the company was forced to raise cash from shareholders. So let's go look at Glencore here, GLEN. We're going to do this on the London Exchange. So Glencore is trading at 296 pence. We bring this back and you'll be able to see how this, pretty amazing. So Glencore, I just brought this back, let's see, it only goes back, looks like 4 years. So it had high out here of 343 pence. That was in August of 2014, and then went south and hit 66 pence. Man. You know, it's amazing, too. You want to see this. You know, so you get a high volume low of 66 pence. You did 996 million shares. You do a countertrend bounce up to 139 pence, which is a double, right? Then you come all the way back down to 69, testing the 66. Unbelievable. And check out how you did it, folks. You tested on the weekly with 468 million versus 996. Now let's put this on the monthly. I'll do 5 years. So on the monthly, this is what you did. Your high volume low had 2.9 billion. And it was $66 pence and 67 cents. We came down to 69.26 with 1.8 versus 2.9. There's a test. And then this is a classic. This is a classic time of the trade. You know, if you haven't checked out time of the trade, folks, you can get it right at Amazon. It's amazing, actually, this how this is unreal. So, and what I mean by classic is this. First, you have to test the low. Had light of volume, rejected the low. Then you come off it with sign of strength. You know, you came off that low. You had a low with 1.8 billion. You come off the low, did 1.8 billion. The following month, you did 1.79 billion. Bottom line, you know, and there's nothing, when you see this going back topside, there was really nothing to stop it on the first leg. But there you go. You know, and commodities can do that. There's no doubt about it. That's pretty intense, though, because that what that company had to do is they had to sell down very, very quickly so that they'd have cash to stay alive. And if you remember, I'm going to show you something here inside the housing business, because to this day, RVLE, let's look at this, because to this day, what happened is you had Lennar sold down quickly. They sold their extra land very, very quickly. And watch this. I'm going to show you the difference. BZA, BZH, inside the crash, did not sell down. And watch the difference here. So if I put this up in a monthly, wow, it's pretty intense, actually. I thought it bounced more than that. It didn't even bounce at all. So, okay, we put this on, let me see, I'll put a 5, I got to put it on a 10-year monthly. So on a 10-year monthly, what you're going to see is this. The 2007 level is $243 in BZA. BZA goes down to $1.20. Now, it's trading at $14.92, okay? But you can see the type of haircut it took. Now, what happened is this. BZA, all these large home builders own plenty of land. What BZA didn't do is cut to the chase, meaning and sell their land very quickly when this crash was taking place. They didn't expect, I'm sure, for it to go down and last as long as it did. Now watch the difference. I'm going to put Lennar up because I remember I actually saw the land that Lennar was selling, you know, just because I happen to know a lot of different places they are in Florida. And what they had done is this, is that they were fast selling the land. And then what they did is that because the land it was going down so much further, they came back and bought all this land for nothing. So watch. Lennar had a high of $56 in 2007. Now, crash-wise, it crashed the same amount, meaning you went from $56 down to $3, $3.42. But guess what? Lennar is almost back to its highs. And the reason being is that in 2007, now watch this, because I remember when they first sold, they sold a whole bunch of land. They sold in 2007, and of course, that was other people thinking that, okay, this will come back. Well, what ended up happening, of course, it didn't. And then in 2008 and 2009, they start buying huge tracts of land back. Because if you remember what also happened there, to keep these, keep anyone alive that was in that business, actually. There was an extension of a law that was passed that instead of going back 3 years on your taxes, you can go back 5 years on your taxes. So what ended up happening is that those large home builders, right, went from a negative to a huge positive because when they were making money, they paid a huge amount of taxes. And then when it got sucked down the tubes, they went back to the government, back to the Treasury Department, got checks, and that got them the cash back in order to turn around and buy huge swaths of land back at as close to the bottom as you can get. But the BZA sign, BZH, is a huge heads up when you want to put stops in, folks, okay? Because every time I keep looking at that chart, I'm saying to myself, look at that. The company that didn't put a stop in, $243, stock's at 14. And the reason that it looks so bizarre there is that they had to do reverse stock splits, folks, is to stay alive, you know. But you can see the difference. At bottom line, when Lennar did it, and Toll Brothers, I believe, also did the same thing. Toll Brothers was also fast to sell the land. They bought it back cheaper too. Yeah, Toll Brothers did the same thing. You can see by looking at the chart. You know, the Toll Brothers, the high there was 58 or 32. You know, Lennard did the best job at it though. Lennard was the fastest to basically move that stuff out. You stay right there, we'll be coming right back. The Dow finished up 297, NASDAQ up 60, S&P's up 26. We're gonna be right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to The Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These 4-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income, much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage, or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at tfnn.com.
Welcome back, folks. And Costco just came out with numbers. So the earnings per share number was $1.19. They made that $1.24. The gross revenue number they didn't make, though. The estimate was $28.3 billion. They came in with $28.1 billion. Costco closed at 153.85. It's not hurting the stock, though. The stock's still trading at 153. So Costco reported fiscal first quarter sales that was shy of analyst estimates, weighed down by declining food prices in the United States. Total revenue was $28.1 billion. Costco has been under pressure this year from food price deflation and rising wages. Like all retailers, it's been facing a growing threat from Amazon. Net income was $1.24 a share in the period ended November 20th, excluding a 7-cent share gain from a legal settlement. Profit was $1.17 a share. Analysts has estimated $1.19. Shares of the company slipped 0.3%, no big deal. Same-store sales, closely watched measure, rose 2% when gas and foreign exchange are excluded. In the United States, where it has more than 500 stores, sales increased 1%. That's shy of the result that rival Walmart, which said last month that same-store sales gained 1.2%. Costco, with a $55 membership, tends to cater to slightly higher-income customers. While those shoppers have fared better during the economic recovery, there's some signs this year that they are pulling back on concerns about the election and volatility inside the stock market. Well, bottom line is that there might be volatility, but that volatility is has gone one way, folks, since the election, and that was been up. It doesn't mean that's going to stay that way, but there's no doubt that when we take a look at where this market has, it's been a one-way trip. If we go to the DAX in Germany, reason I'm bringing up the DAX broke out today. DAX wants higher price, you know, so waking up in Europe tomorrow, bottom line, the DAX took out that 10,800 and get 9,800. What is it, $1,000? No, 93. It is, 1 second, hold it. 9,200. My God, that's a huge one. Okay, so you get 9,200, you get 1,600. Which would get you 11,700 almost. That's a long way from where we are right now. Oh, I see what's up here. Okay. Interesting. The high is 12,390. Yeah, this is going, the DAX is going to try to charge into this 11,800 mark. So, bottom line is that the transports close at highs today. The S&Ps close at highs today. The Dow close at highs. The Russell 2000 close at highs. The only major index, well, when you take a look out here, is the NASDAQ Composite, which is right next to it. It's high. We are at 53.93, and the high is 54.03. And the NDX 100, that is the weak dog, which is so unusual, folks. That's bottom line. That's how it is. You know, it's like, okay, how are all these big industrial companies going to make money? I'm not quite sure. But the NDX, we're at 48.51, 49.11 is the high. That high was generated in October of 2016. Yeah, that's your high. Your high from last month is 48.96. It's trying to make it into that first. It's going to be intriguing to watch this shake out because, you know, what you do have is the Dow stocks are up. And as I said a little bit earlier, the new highs versus the new lows, you get a monster of new highs. No two ways about that. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, fly with it. Everything you need is right inside you, folks. Go have a blast with it. Thanks for being here. Have a great night, safe night. Look forward to speaking it right back here tomorrow morning, 8 o'clock. Wow! Go get them, folks.
Platinum, grains, crude oil, gold, copper, cattle, hogs, gasoline, natural gas, coffee, cotton, cocoa, and sugar. These are just some of the commodities mentioned in the most recent issue of Andy Hecht's Technomental Commodity Report. Andy publishes his weekly newsletter every Thursday morning, where he breaks down the commodity market and provides his subscribers with specific trading recommendations based on his trading methodology. By signing up for a free trial to the Technomental Commodity Report, you'll get a full 30 days to try out this powerful newsletter service and see for yourself the types of trades Andy has recommended for his subscribers. When you sign up for a 30-day free trial, you're under no obligation to pay anything. And should you decide to continue, you will lock in the low rate of only $79 a month. Sign up right now for the Technomental Commodity Report and make sure you're ready to catch the next big trade in commodities. For more information and to get started today, visit the front page of TFNN.com.
This is TFNN.
The following.
following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Seem in Dallas.
Hi, Tom. I love your show.
Thank you so much.
I've been listening to you since 2001 from my Seattle days when you were on a little station there.
I appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here, man. Thank you. Well, listen, thanks for bringing us from Seattle to Dallas, man. Appreciate it.
Yeah. I love all the hosts. I love your show. I'm addicted to it.
That's Hotel California. It's wicked, isn't it, man? Thanks.
All right, Tom. Nice to talk to you.
Have a great one. All right. Have a safe one.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Learn to ask questions. It is always better to ask questions than to make an assumption. Have the courage to ask questions and to as clear as you can be. Once you hear the answer to the question, you won't have to make the assumption because you will know the truth. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We had the Dow Industrials finish up 297 points. NASDAQ up 60, S&P's up 27. Gold contract up $4.50, trading at $1,174.50 an ounce. Silver up 38 cents at $17.19 an ounce. Platinum up $6, $9.41 an ounce. Copper down 3.5 pennies at $2.63 a pound. Light sweet crude off $1, trading at $49.91 a barrel. Bonds, the 10-year note up 11 ticks, 124.26. 30-year bond up 28 ticks, 151.05. King dollar down 295 ticks, trading at 100.235. The euro is at 107. And the yen is trading at 113.78. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? Okay, you broke out. You ripped the 2213 apart. You're at 2237 on the cash S&P. Volume-wise, what we have out here, this is what you have. You're in with a billion versus 885 million yesterday. Dow Industrials make another new high. Dow Industrials up 297 points. You have wide price spread. I mean, this is pretty intense. You're also at a price point of 19,558. That was the high you hit. It's like, okay, why not hit 20,000, right? That's what it kind of seems like, folks. That's the bottom line. Composite, NASDAQ composite. Now, this is where it gets a little bit different. The composite had the price spread, good price spread, $60. You didn't do the volume, you did 2 billion shares. Well, you're going into the highs. These highs will get hit tomorrow. So you get 54.03. And right now we're at 53.93. You know, bottom line, I expect you're going to see them get hit. If you do that correlation, when you're looking at how we've come into this, you know, the price spread's a big deal. You've come into it with 2 billion shares. That's versus the 2.2 billion on the way down, the 2 billion on the way down. So we'll see where that whole thing does shake out. The NDX 100. Now, this is still the weak link. It's pretty amazing, actually. So the NDX, the high of the NDX is 49.11. We're at 48.51. Bottom line, go over to the Qs. You can see the Qs. Folks just aren't buying the tech stocks. The Qs did 25 million shares, which is a good jump up from where we were at 20 past 3, because we were 21 million. But still not huge. We last high we made out here was at 18 million, and I gave it up with 30. Right now, the Qs are trading at $118.36. The 119.51 is the last high that was generated up here on the 29th. The low of that high was 118.30. You know, so you whack that high, you get into it, you close the into it, 6 pennies, that says the top of that will now get hit. Gold contract. What do we have with gold? Gold contract out here traded from a price point today of 1167 to 1182. We're at 1175. Good volume. What I do want to see inside this contract, though, we need more price spread. I do expect we're going to see it test the 1190. We'll see whether it has the strength as it gets up into that level. Silver is proving itself out here today. Silver, if you happen to be in the metals market, silver is a good indication that it's going to drag gold higher with it. And what you have is this. Silver did 62,000 contracts. You're up 37 cents. We hit a high today of $17.30. A close inside $17.24 to 26 cents will put you in the higher range. The higher range specifically is after it got toasted and roasted on the 11th of November. That's when we went down and all the metals. Silver happened to go from $18.95 to $17.20. Notes and bonds. Notes and bonds are still trying to get off their lows. It's doing like a, if you just take a horseshoe and put it as a horseshoe is, that's what we're doing off these lows. So in this contract here, meaning we're in the March 2017 contract, the low of that this contract on the 10-year is 123.19. Right now you're at 124.26. And, you know, we did 800,000 contracts. The bonds, the notes, need like 1.2 million contracts. We go up and we take a look at the bonds, and what you have with the bonds, we did 167,000 contracts. What we want to see is 267,000. So we want to see another 100,000 contracts, big numbers that we're going to need in those bonds for higher price. King Dollar, what do we have with King Dollar? Bottom line, King Dollar is having a hard time holding the 100.600 mark. King Dollar, it looks like it's an ABC structure on the way down. You know, we broke with wide price spread and accelerated volume on Monday. You did a counter trend bounce today and yesterday. You can see the correlation down with 80,000 contracts, up yesterday with 32,000. You got to a higher high today with 26, gave it up on price. It's going to go after the B point tomorrow, which is $99.87. And we'll see whether we get an ABC structure on the way down. The amazing part about this, at this particular point, it's like, guess what? When the dollar was going up, the market was going up. The dollar's going down, the market's still going up. So the correlation of the dollar right now doesn't seem to matter which way the dollar goes. The market continues to go at a higher price. We look at the XAU. The XAU is trading at $82.57. And this already got back inside its higher range. Inside $79.88 gets it back inside the range, which it did. Gold Bugs Index still needs some help. That's at 183. Volume wasn't bad the last couple days, but Gold Bugs Index has a much further reach in order to get back inside that range. That would have to be up to the $195.61. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'd be coming back. Lululemon. Let's see. Lululemon closed at $59.84. That is trading at $66.51. They just come up with numbers. We'll come back with those numbers for you. Be right back.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit TFNN.com.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at nadex.com. That's nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of tfnn.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go over to Lululemon and see what they have to say. So, okay, so Lululemon, their margin, the estimated margin was 49.3%. They got their margins up to 51%. The earnings, 43 cents was the estimate. They made 47. Net revenue, okay, so for the year, they had seen... for the year, they see net revenue of $2.3 billion to $2.34 billion. Fourth quarter net revenue, they see from $765 million to $785 million. So the fourth quarter is a big quarter for them. No two ways about that. Lululemon soared as much as 14% late trading after third quarter earnings, blew past analyst estimates, and the yoga wear maker said sales have strengthened heading into holiday season. Profit in the quarter was 47 cents a share, excluding some items. The Vancouver-based company said in a statement Wednesday, the results suggest Lululemon has renewed momentum following concerns that discounting and sluggish retail traffic would weigh on sales. Lululemon closed at, closed at $59.84. That is trading now at $66. And if we take a look at this, so Lululemon, this just came down from 81. So it was trading 81 in August, gets down to 54, going back up to 66. So you're going back up to where the stock got toasted in September. The week of September, first week of September, Lululemon went from $79 to 68. Now coming right back into that area. We'll see whether it can take that area out. If we put this on a larger monthly, what you're going to see is that Lululemon's still in a consolidation. That's how it's shaken out. And now it wants to run to the top of that consolidation. We take a look at the XLF. So what was kind of intriguing out here today, you know, the XLF goes to a new high. New high meaning in the last couple of years. Well, the last couple of years, I believe it is. Yeah, it is. We are at we're at a price point of 23.48. But if we go over to J.P. Morgan, it was interesting. Yeah, J.P. Morgan's up 38 cents. BRK I believe Berkshire Hathaway is the largest weighting inside. Oh, there she is. Yep. So Berkshire Hathaway was up 335. Berkshire, this is pretty amazing. For Berkshire, since the election, has gone from 145 to 164. You talk about putting some juice into a stock. Pretty amazing. If you want to see something that's really bizarre, so check this out. We'll go to the, let's see, changes up. I'll go to the A shares of Berkshire Hathaway. So the A shares of Berkshire Hathaway right now trade at $246,380.05. They're up $4,500 today. And so check this out. You're going to love this. There was 830 shares traded today at $250,000 apiece, approximately. Pretty amazing. We bring this back. Let's put this back. So here, I got to see this in this context. Okay. So if you bought Berkshire Hathaway, it's percentage-wise at the same, but man, this is big money. If you had bought it the day of the election, it was $219,000. It's $246,000 now. And when you put this on a monthly basis, your swing point had 9,800. Well, this is intense. So check this out. Wow. Man, this is going to be a trip if this is a... It looks like it's an ABC up. Okay, so let me find this. This could be insane. Okay, so on Berkshire Hathaway... Yeah, it broke a B point with volume. The real question is, let me put this on a... Oh, that's on a monthly. Wow. Okay. It's pretty cool. Let me see which point I'm going to come off here for a second. You can just about do it. Okay. This is going to be close. What the close call is, folks, is that when we get an ABC up, you need straight line moves. And then you need... You can't do more than a 0.618 retracement. So this is a ballpark, but it looks like 163 to 229. You got what that's 37, 47, 57, 67, which would give you 714. I see. Yeah. It's a little bit higher than this, 256, around 256. Right now, you're at 146. Pretty intense, no doubt. Let's go take a look at Toll Brothers. So Toll Brothers came out with numbers yesterday. Numbers weren't bad. Toll Brothers are going $32.61. Now, this took out its last swing point. And if we put this, it's going to need a lot more juice on the weekly. But it looks like right now, the Toll Brothers on its way to a 34.49. Let's go take a look at Lennar. Because what you have, the amount of bread, that has been generated in this market that are going to be people's accounts is pretty intense. There's no doubt about that, whether the IRAs or whatever. Lennar is up $1.25 at $44.69. Looks like it wants to go after. What we also have out here, which is a little bit different in the context of the market going up this dramatically, you also had bonds go up. When you get a market that runs like this, it's like totally makes sense that bonds would go down, but guess what? They didn't. There was actually nothing that was going down at all. Well, actually, except gasoline. If we go over to the gasoline market, you'll see that number two, unleaded, came off the highs. We are trading at a price point of $1.52. The highs 2 days ago is $1.58, and that's back inside the range. So back inside the range, that says that, longer term, meaning next 4-6 weeks, whatever, that can get back down to 128. Now, if we bring this back a little bit further, XB1. Okay, so I put this on a continuous contract. Oh, yeah, it's just... Okay, so on a continuous contract, what it did is this. We got to the top of the consolidation, and it just couldn't handle it. If you, when we go back in 2014, of course, unleaded gas wholesale was $3.15. Crashed down to the January of 2015 to 122. It's been this consolidation now, the one we're in since August of 2016. The top of that consolidation is $1.66. The bottom of this consolidation is 127. So regardless of the Saudis saying that they're going to keep the price of crude up, the distillates, the gasolines, bottom line, looks like there's plenty of them and they're going south. Dow Industrials finished up 297, NASDAQ up 60, S&P's up 26. You stay right there, folks. We'll come right back.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
It's 2016 and TFNN has a brand new programming lineup to kick things off. Starting January 4th, Swim Lessons by Thinkorswim and TD Ameritrade will be airing 5 days a week at noon Eastern Time. Join hosts Scott Connor, Kevin Hinks, and Cindy Faber as they host their daily options program live at noon 5 days a week with no commercials for the entire hour. Nico DeHaan and Paige Clark will be moving their program, Living a Primal Lifestyle, to twice a week, Tuesdays and Thursdays from 7 a.m. until 8 a.m. Eastern Time. Wake up with Nico and Paige and start your day off right. The Bull Bear Binary Option Hour by Nadex will now be live Mondays and Fridays at 10 a.m. Start and end the week with the three hosts, Tom O'Brien, Tommy O'Brien, and Daryl Martin, as they break down the world of trading binary options and spreads. For all the details on the new 2016 programming lineup, visit the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. And there was there's a great question that's in the den, folks. And what it was is this: can this market rally to a year end without a week long pullback? And I answered yes, sick and yes. I remember 1999. So here, let's do this first. I want to go. I believe the biggest run thus far has been the Dow. So the Dow has gone from 18,200 to 19,000. So that's gone up 1,300 points. Big numbers. And huge numbers, no doubt. And there's another question, no shots left to push it, so we'll have to be buying, okay? So the speculation would be, and I think the speculation is correct, outside of the NDX 100, is that when you get an expansion like this with the type of price spread, inside the S&Ps, people are flat. If they don't want to go long, they're flat. They're not shot any longer. Now, what I want to do, though, is I'm going to go back. I'm going to pull up the NDX for us. I'm going to pull up the NASDAQ composite for us because I believe that the run in 1999 was 30% in 6 weeks. I mean, I remember this because I remember we had a couple ABC structures on the way up. JDSU, we did, it was a 225-point ABC structure on the way up. It was insane, and it hit it like in 3 weeks. Yeah, so if we go back there, I got this up here right now. So if we go back, what you're going to see, this is crazy, actually. Yeah, in September, the NASDAQ was at 2,600. And by March, it was 51. Yeah, so that's, okay, so it doubled from September to March. Just September to the end of the year, it went from 2,600 to 4,000. So, yeah, Qualcomm. Oh, yeah, Qualcomm, man. That was a Qualcomm 220. Yeah, it was Qualcomm. Was it Qualcomm? I forget. It didn't matter what you bought. It was crazy. Let's go to Brent in Martinez, California. Hey, Brent, what's going on, brother?
Hey, Tom, how are you?
Doing great, man. Yourself?
I'm doing well, thank you.
Cool.
I'd like to take a little bit of your time to ask more of a general question about the mining stocks.
Yeah.
And specifically what I would like to know is regionally, if you had a choice, I don't do a lot of fundamental, but you see, you obviously know more about that than I do. As far as like the United States, Mexico, it seems to me that the South African stocks are having some trouble. And is there something politically there that you know about? Right? That's what I kind of want to know from you. What areas you would prefer to be in as far as regionally, what you prefer?
The best deal, this is how this kind of works. So check this out. So you have, it has the mining business in general, folks, right? And the commodities are all run by the U.S. dollar. So what ends up happening is that when on your balance sheet, if in fact you have, if you're dealing in U.S. dollars and you're getting paid in U.S. dollars, it's a lot easier to figure out fundamentally what's going on with the stock, okay? That's why what happens there is that when you do see that they're both going up pretty good, you get McEwen Mining. I mean, almost his whole business is in Nevada, okay? So that's pretty good, okay, in that aspect, right? Now let's go over to the South Africa, right? Two different things end up happening in South Africa. So let's bring up Harmony first. We can bring up Harmony. So Harmony's trading at a low, $2.22. This was the first equity that actually took off in January, right? I mean, November, this equity's 54 cents, and then the thing took off to $4, right? Now, what that was all about, and this would be the ultimate in really making money, and what it is that the Rand dollar, you know, went up to 17.9 Rand dollars to one U.S. dollar. Now we're at 13.4 Rand dollars to one U.S. dollar. So what happens here is this, is that they have a law in South Africa. They can't keep U.S. dollars. They can't, in fact, keep anything except the Rand. They have to transfer it, and I believe it's within 90 days they get a transfer. They have a whole structure how to do it. So what happens is this, is that everyone gets paid in Rand dollars in South Africa, including in mining. Harmony. Harmony has 27,000 employees. So when the Rand dollar was getting so weak, and then you had the gold contract getting strong, that was the best of both worlds for them. That's why that stock went from, you know, 50 cents to whatever, $5 or whatever it was. Okay, so now let's talk about the Canadian stocks. What happens with the Canadian stocks, let's go over to GG. And you have Goldcorp, and Goldcorp is going to have their expenses in Canadian dollars, and they're still getting paid in American dollars. So it's like, okay, you know, the Canadian dollar right now is at $1.32. You know, you're down from 146, thank God. You know, it looks to me that, and this is where it would help the Canadian stock, if I'm right on the dollar call, Brent, meaning the dollar's going to pull back, the Canadian dollar will get stronger, and we don't want it to get really strong, because if it gets really strong, then what ends up happening is that hurts the Canadian stocks too. So you got to pay attention to what their expenses are in. That's what it really comes down to, man, you know?
Okay, so it's more of a currency issue than politically being a problem.
Yeah, yes, it is. Yeah, for sure. It's the cross trade of what
their currency is to our dollar.
Yeah, exactly. Because they're getting paid in U.S. dollars. Yeah.
Okay.
Exactly.
All right. Go ahead.
If you go over to Rangold, what Rangold does is this. Now, Rangold, folks, their business, a lot of their business is in West Africa. And, you know, what they do, they have a lot of euros and a lot of dollars. That's how they kind of do it. They don't deal in, you know, the West currency, the currency in West Africa. You know, so.
Okay, so they're not so tied to the Rand like Harmony is.
They are not.
Okay.
Right.
Okay.
Harmony is definitely tied to the Rand. And then what also happens is that Harmony and Goldfields, the difference is that they take out millions of ounces of gold, right? But it's a very high cost. So what happens is this, is that as gold's, out here 1175, they're probably still just breaking even, okay? You go up $200, though, and what ends up happening is that's where you'll see that expansion in the South African stocks because of the fact that these other equities, let's say these other equities are taking out 600,000 ounces a year, which is still a lot. Harmony's taking out 2 million ounces a year, you know? So they're acceleration and the amount of leverage that they have when the price of gold gets higher goes astronomical, you know.
Okay, that makes sense.
And here, I'm going to show you something else out here, folks. Okay, now we own this stock, but I can tell you, when this stock starts moving, you watch that gold market. When Vista Gold starts moving, which it did, just went from 85 cents to $1.10 in 2 days, 3 days, that's a good indication. And this is this is still an exploration play, and it's a play on Australia. But that's always a good indication that these equities want to move higher. Cooking, brother.
All right. Thank you, Tom. Take care.
You too. Thanks for the call. Stay right there, folks. We're coming right back.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a 2-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing.
Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
Take your phone calls
now.
Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. And, you know, in the commodity business, you talk about a comeback. This is pretty amazing because, you know, of course, you know, we have the Tiger's Den, which is a trading room, folks. If you haven't test drove it yet, come on over to TFNN. Great time to test drive it. You know, but I remember last year, we're talking many times inside here. Glencore was a company that no doubt looked like it was just going out of business. I mean, big time, too. Well, guess what? In the course of 1 year, they not only came back, and they sold a huge amount of assets, too, to stay in business. But bottom line, when you know how to cut to the chase, which this CEO did, guess what? He's back, and he's back, and he's bold. This just came across the tape. Russia sold 11.3 billion stake in its largest oil producer, the commodity trader Glencore PLC, and Qatar's sovereign wealth fund in a triumph for President Putin, who announced the deal on state television. The reason it would be a triumph, folks, yeah, I'll read this through, is because of the sanctions that are on Russia right now. You know, internationally, give me a break. It doesn't matter. You get oil, someone's going to buy it. And a surprise deal that leaves the EU sanctions against Russia looking pretty threadbare. The buyers will share a 19.5% stake in the state-run company, which pumps 5 million barrels a day, the biggest investment in Russia since the crisis in Ukraine. It also marks a stunning return to deal-making for Glencore CEO Ivan Glasenberg, little more than a year after the company was forced to raise cash from shareholders. So let's go look at Glencore here, GLEN. We're going to do this on the London Exchange. So Glencore is trading at 296 pence. We bring this back and you'll be able to see how this, pretty amazing. So Glencore, I just brought this back, let's see, it only goes back, looks like 4 years. So it had high out here of 343 pence. That was in August of 2014, and then went south and hit 66 pence. You know, it's amazing, too. You want to see this. You know, so you get a high volume low of 66 pence. You did 996 million shares. You do a counter trend bounce up to 139 pence, which is a double, right? Then you come all the way back down to 69, testing the 66. Unbelievable. And check out how you did it, folks. You tested on the weekly with 468 million versus 996. Now let's put this on the monthly. I'll do 5 years. So on the monthly, this is what you did. Your high volume low had 2.9 billion. And it was $66.66 and 67 cents. We came down to 69.26 with 1.8 versus 2.9. There's your test. And then this is a classic. This is a classic time in the trade. You know, if you haven't checked out time in the trade, folks, you can get it right at Amazon. It's amazing, actually. This how this is unreal. So, and what I mean by classic is this. First, you have to test the low. Had lighter volume, rejected the low. Then you come off it with sign of strength. You know, you came off that low, You had a low with $1.8 billion. You come off the low, did $1.8 billion. The following month, you did $1.79 billion. Bottom line, you know, and there's nothing, when you see this going back topside, there was really nothing to stop it on the first leg. But there you go. You know, and commodities can do that. There's no doubt about it. That's pretty intense, though, because that what that company had to do is they had to sell down very, very quickly so that they'd have cash to stay alive. And if you remember, I'm going to show you something here inside the housing business, because to this day, RVLEN, let's look at this, because to this day, what happened is you had Lennar sold down quickly. They sold their extra land very, very quickly. And watch this, I'm going to show you the difference. Beza, BZH, inside the crash, did not sell down. And watch the difference here. So if I put this up in a monthly, wow, it's pretty intense, actually. Thought it bounced more than that. It didn't even bounce at all. So, okay, we put this on, let me see, I'll put a five, I gotta put it on a 10-year monthly. So on a 10-year monthly, what you're gonna see is this. The 2007 level is $243 in Beza. Beza goes down to $1.20. Now, it's trading at $14.92, okay? But you can see the type of haircut it took. Now, what happened is this. Beza, all these large home builders own plenty of land. What Beza didn't do is cut to the chase, meaning and sell their land very quickly when this crash was taking place. They didn't expect, I'm sure, for it to go down and last as long as it did. Now watch the difference. I'm going to put Lennar up because I remember I actually saw the land that Lennar was selling, you know, just because I happen to know a lot of different places they are in Florida. And what they had done is this, is that they were fast selling the land. And then what they did is that because the land it was going down so much further, they came back and bought all this land for nothing. So watch, Lennar had a high of $56 in 2007. Now, crash-wise, it crashed the same amount, meaning you went from $56 down to $3, $3.42. But guess what? Lennar is almost back to its highs. And the reason being is that in 2007, now watch this, because I remember when they first sold, they sold a whole bunch of land. They sold in 2007, and of course, that was other people thinking that, okay, this will come back. Well, what ended up happening, of course, it didn't. And then in 2008 and 2009, they start buying huge tracts of land back. Because if you remember what also happened there, to keep these, keep anyone alive that was in that business, actually. There was an extension of a law that was passed that instead of going back 3 years on your taxes, you can go back 5 years on your taxes. So what ended up happening is that those large home builders, right, went from a negative to a huge positive because when they were making money, they paid a huge amount of taxes. And then when it got sucked down the tubes, they went back to the government, back to the Treasury Department, got checks, and that got them the cash back in order to turn around and buy huge swaths of land back at as close to the bottom as you can get. But the Beza sign, BZH, is a huge heads up when you want to put stops in, folks, okay? Because every time I keep looking at that chart, I'm saying to myself, look at that. The company that didn't put a stop in, $243, stock's at 14. And the reason that it looks so bizarre there is that they had to do reverse stock splits, folks, is to stay alive, you know? But you can see the difference. Bottom line, when Lennar did it, and Toll Brothers, I believe, also did the same thing. Toll Brothers was also fast to sell the land. They bought it back cheaper, too. Yeah, Toll Brothers did the same thing. You can see by looking at the chart. You know, the Toll Brothers, the high there was 58 or 32. You know, Lennar did the best job at it, though. Lennar was the fastest to basically move that stuff out. You stay right there. We'll be coming right back. The Dow finished up 267, 297. NASDAQ up 60. S&P's up 26. We're going to be right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These 4-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income, much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage, or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. And Costco just came out with numbers. So the earnings per share number was $1.19. They made that $1.24. The gross revenue number they didn't make, though. The estimate was $28.3 billion. They came in with $28.1 billion. Costco closed at 153.85. It's not hurting the stock, though. The stock's still trading at 153. So Costco reported fiscal first quarter sales that were shy of analyst estimates, weighed down by declining food prices in the United States. Total revenue was $28.1 billion. Costco has been under pressure this year from food price deflation and rising wages. Like all retailers, it's been facing a growing threat from Amazon. Net income was $1.24 a share in the period ended November 20th, excluding a 7-cent share gain from a legal settlement. Profit was $1.17 a share. Analysts has estimated $1.19. Shares of the company slipped 0.3%. No big deal. Same store sales, closely watched measure, rose 2% when gas and foreign exchange are excluded. In the United States, where it has more than 500 stores, sales increased 1%. That's shy of the result that rival Walmart, which said last month that same-store sales gained 1.2%. Costco, with a $55 membership, tends to cater to slightly higher-income customers. While those shoppers have fared better during the economic recovery, there's some signs this year that they are pulling back on concerns about the election and volatility inside the stock market. Well, bottom line is that there might be volatility, but that volatility is has gone one way, folks, since the election, and that was been up. It doesn't mean that's going to stay that way. But there's no doubt that when we take a look at where this market has, it's been a one-way trip. If we go to the DAX in Germany, reason I'm bringing up the DAX broke out today. DAX wants higher price, you know, so waking up in Europe tomorrow, bottom line, the DAX took out that 10,800 and get 9,800. What is it, $1,000? No, 93. It is, 1 second, hold it. 9,200. My God, that's a huge one. Okay, so you get 9,200, you get 1,600. Which would get you 11,700 almost. That's a long way from where we are right now. Oh, I see what's up here. Okay. And just the high is 12,390. Yeah, this is going, the DAX is going to try to charge into this 11,800 mark. So, bottom line is that the transports close at highs today. The S&Ps closed at highs today. The Dow closed at highs. The Russell 2000 closed at highs. The only major indice, well, when you take a look out here, is the NASDAQ Composite, which is right next to it. It's high. We are at 53.93, and the high is 54.03. And the NDX 100, that is the weak dog, which is so unusual, folks. That is death. That is just that bottom line. That's how it is. You know, it's like, okay, how are all these big industrial companies going to make money? I'm not quite sure. But the NDX, we're at 48.51, 49.11 is the high. That high was generated in October of 2016. Yeah, that's a high. Your high from last month is 48.96. It's trying to make it into that first. It's going to be intriguing to watch this shake out because, you know, what you do have is the Dow stocks are up. And as I said a little bit earlier, the new highs versus the new lows, you got a monster of new highs. No two ways about that. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, fly with it. Everything you need is right inside you, folks. Go have a blast with it. Thanks for being here. Have a great night, safe night. Look forward to speaking it right back here tomorrow morning, 8 o'clock. Bam! Go get them, folks.
Platinum, grains, crude oil, gold, copper, cattle, hogs, gasoline, natural gas, coffee, cotton, cocoa, and sugar. These are just some of the commodities mentioned in the most recent issue of Andy Hecht's Technomental Commodity Report. Andy publishes his weekly newsletter every Thursday morning, where he breaks down the commodity market and provides his subscribers with specific trading recommendations based on his trading methodology. By signing up for a free trial to the Technomental Commodity Report, you'll get a full 30 days to try out this powerful newsletter service and see for yourself the types of trades Andy has recommended for his subscribers. When you sign up for a 30-day free trial, you're under no obligation to pay anything. And should you decide to continue, you'll lock in the low rate of only $79 a month. Sign up right now for the Technomental Commodity Report and make sure you're ready to catch the next big trade in commodities. For more information and to get started today, visit the front page of TFNN.com.
This is TFNN.